Deep beneath the frostbacked mountains sits Orzammar, the larger of two known remaining dwarven cities in the world. Orzammar was once the seat of a major empire connected by tunnels called Deep Roads, which stretched thousands of miles. The city now stands alone, cut off from the rest of the dwarven ancestral lands by the Darkspawn incursion. Secure in Orzammar's impregnable construction, the dwarven noble houses continue their centuries-old power struggles. Assassination and blackmail are commonplace, but the appearance of honor is paramount. You are the second child of King Endran of House Idukan, the ninth Idukan ruler elected by the noble assembly. You grew up in a world rife with political intrigue, and have struggled against brothers and cousins for honor and prestige. Today, a feast celebrates your first military commission, the opening move towards real power in the ever-changing game of dwarven politics.
Greetings, my lady. You are dressed and ready. Excellent. I couldn't find the armor's matching dagger, but I scrounged up a rather fancy longsword. Do you wish to wear your shield to the noble's feast? As opposed to the paragon of beauty? One can't take all this marching about and speech-making too seriously. Moving on to the business at hand. The king expects you to make an appearance at the feast, but there's no rush. The noble family heads will spend hours boring your father with petitions and petty grievances. The usual. This lord had my cousin killed, this lord seduced my wife, this lord did the exact thing I'd planned to do to him, but he did it first. They pose and bluster, and each pretends he is the honorable man in a den of thieves and assassins. Bah! The rest is worth seeing, though. As part of the celebrations, permits have been auctioned off to members of the merchant caste who wish to sell wares in the Diamond Quarter. Lord Harrowmont has also opened up the provings for young warriors to test their mettle before tomorrow's battle. Rumor has it that Harrowmont hopes you'll be swept off your feet if a well-placed young nobleman wins the provings in your honor. Win the proving in your own honor? That would be most interesting. Shall we then? With you as always, my lady. The day is ours until the feast.
Congratulations on being named commander, my lady. I am proud to serve the Idukans.
Bhelen? Oh! Oh! I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry. I thought you were Prince Bhelen coming down the hall. Forgive me.
She's, It seems she's one of your brother Balin's newest, companions. Prince Bhelen is attending the feast being held in Lady Iduken's honor.
Yes, of course. It was presumptuous of me to think that he would return to... I am sorry. I will show myself out. With your leave, my lady. Thank you. I will go now.
As you say.
Your father has allowed the merchants to show their wares in the Diamond Quarter during these celebrations.
I'm sure we can work this out reasonably. It's in the records. There's nothing I can do. Please, Master Volney. My work is accredited by the Shaper.
These books are lies written by the enemies of House Volney.
I write only what I find in the ancient records. Lady Iduken, you can vouch for my work, can't you? Your father loved my History of Iduken, Paragon King, Peacemaker.
This worm has written a book that slanders my house. He deserves to die for what he has written of Paragon Volney.
My work tells the stories of all those raised paragons in the last 500 years. When the Assembly names a paragon, that man or woman is then, by definition, everything one can aspire to be in the world. They form their own noble houses and are revered as living ancestors. But paragons start off as men.
Volney was more than a man.
Iduken was much loved, but he was still a man. He was plagued by melancholy, and his fervor regarding Orzammar's safety bordered on obsession. When Iduken was proposed as a paragon, only one lord in the Assembly objected. The others savagely hacked him to death. Iduken's motion passed without a single dissenting vote.
Unlike Volney, is that what you mean, old man?
Volney became a paragon by the narrowest margin in history. One vote. A vote mired in rumors of intimidation, intrigue, and outright bribery. The records of that vote are kept in the Shaperate and are a matter of fact. Not liking history doesn't make it any less true.
You're taking his side? What if he published a book like this about your Paragon Iduken? You would not say so if it was your house, but I shall respect your wishes. For now, excuse me, Your Highness.
That fool has no idea how weak his house is or how low he sits in it. Shall I have him killed, my lady?
Well, historically, it has been prudent to eliminate a small threat before it becomes larger.
As you say.
You've shown House Idukin a friend to research, history, and the glory of our people. Of course. I have much to document and organize. Good day, Your Highness, and thank you.
That's outrageous. You certainly have some gall, merchant.
But my lord, these are surface silks, dyed with the finest saffron and indigo, and embroidered by skilled elven tradesmen. I've seen Prince Bhelen Idukin himself wearing a robe made of something quite... My Lady Idukin, you honor me by visiting my humble booth. May I show you my wares? Please, look as you will.
Trust follow, big sister. How surprising to run into you out among the common folk.
Especially since duty requires that you attend our King Father at the feast today. Have you so little respect for him to disregard his wishes on a day set aside for you?
Lord Harrowmont told me we wouldn't be needed for hours at least.
Silence! If I want the opinion of my sibling second, I will ask for it.
Yes, Your Highness.
Your lack of a sense of duty to your house is obvious. I can't imagine why you are receiving a commission. I expect after tomorrow I'll spend much time apologizing to the heads of the noble houses for the deaths of their children under your incompetent command.
That's a bit harsh, isn't it, Trian?
As heir to the throne, it is my duty to impart wisdom and judgment upon those who need it. Now then, you, get to the feast! Stubborn, aren't you? When I'm king, I will help you get over that. Come, Bhelen.
That was fun. Nothing like being talked down to by the next king. We can only hope. Perhaps we should get going.
My Lady Idukin, nothing here rivals your amazing Idukin armor, but if you wish something made...
You know very well House Idukin has its own royal armorers.
Of course. Forgive me. You honor me, Your Highness.
Look at this piece, darling. It rivals even the work of the Paragon Smith herself.
Nonsense, woman. Your words bring shame upon our house. See how the edges are rough and pitted? Would you compare this to Bronca's work? Trust a woman to speak of things she doesn't understand. Be quiet now and pray the ancestors deliver Bronca back safely.